All right, everybody. Well, I'm here in the laundry room again today. And what I want to show you is how you can get your Speed Queen 8 or 9 series machine to sort of give you a warm rinse option, okay? Now, before I go any further into this, there's a reason why I'm saying sort of, okay? And here it is. What I'm going to show you, you're going to have to do manually every single time you want to do this, okay? For the most part, this is not a set it and forget it kind of thing, all right? Every time you want to have the machine do this, you're going to have to kind of watch it and set it up yourself, okay? Now let me show you what I'm talking about. I want to thank YouTube user M. Buck for showing this to me because he left this comment back when I did the my video on my opinions on the electronic controls for Speed Queen, okay? I had said that when you set this to spin, okay, I had said that you can still select these options if you want to, and I wasn't really sure when you would ever use that, but apparently, if you remember, when I hit pre-wash, it would let you select the water level and the temperature that you want, and this is kind of how the warm rinse option comes into play. So as you know, both the 8 and the 9 series machine have a pre-wash option, so this is possible to do on both those machines. On the 8WN432, which is the mechanical control model, this isn't really as much of an option, but you could always turn the timer back to wash to get a warm thing, and you know I'm going there, okay? So what's going to happen is, let's say you're running, we'll just do a regular cycle here, okay? So it does its thing, whatever, and then it's in the first spin, and it's just about done, and it's going to fill for the rinse, okay? So what you would do in this regard is, there's Marco again. What you would do in this regard is, you would hit this button, which would cancel the cycle, put it back to the beginning, okay? And then what you would do is, you would go over to spin, okay? Then select pre-wash, and whatever water level you're using, just put it back to that. There's Marco again. And in this case, you want to rinse your laundry and warm. So set this to warm, and then you would hit start. And then whatever water level and whatever temperature you have it set at, that's what it's going to do for you. So like I said, once the machine is pretty much done with the first spin, let me go over it again. You're in this cycle, whatever portion, hit this to cancel the cycle. Go over to spin, okay, select pre-wash, and then go over to warm, so you can do a warm rinse. You could even do a hot rinse if you want, but to my knowledge, even back in the 60s, that was never used. And then hit start, and then it's going to fill up with warm water for the rinse. Now, this is the part where, you know, it's gotta be manually done. You have to select spin and pre-wash every time you want to do this, okay, because the machine's not going to do that automatically for you. And that's where, like, the manual portion of it comes in. Now, I'm sure for some people, this really, you may feel, is unnecessary. You might not really use it that much. But there are a couple of times where this may come in handy for you, okay? Let's say your cold water temperature is greatly affected by the summer and winter months. It may not be a bad idea to use this in the winter. And another good time to use it is that if you use liquid fabric softener, we don't. But if you do use this and the water is very, very cold, it may not mix very well in with the laundry when you're trying to use that. So what you can do is, if you do this option, like I said, when it's time for rinse, you'll get warm water with your fabric softener and it should mix it in very well. Or if just in general, let's say you're more comfortable with your laundry being rinsed in warm water, you can do this then as well. So let me go ahead and show you just how this does truly work as stated. Okay, so I just purged the hot water line. Got my thermometer here. We'll see if it reads the water temperature correctly. Okay, and then let's give this a start. Take the water, just as you can see. Okay, so we'll wait for this to, wait for the hot water to get here. It's just pretty warm already. All right, so then let's see if the thermometer can accurately measure the temperature of this water. Let's see. Yeah, check that out. About 94 degrees. The really cold water is coming in, so that's why it's going down a bit. But yeah, look at that. About 94 degrees Fahrenheit. So that just goes to show you that the water coming in is indeed warm. Now do it again. Yep, look at that. So that just goes to show you, if you set it up this way, you can get a warm rinse. If you set it to warm wash and warm temperature, whatever, and whatever level you want, and then hit spin with pre-wash, what it's going to do is, after the pre-wash portion is done, it's just going to spin the water out, and that's the end of the cycle. So you can see, you can actually get a warm rinse in some way with your washing machine, with the 8 and the 9 series. Pretty cool. Let's stop it. Okay, we'll just, there you go, set it back to that, and then let spin out the water. And there you go, guys. So basically, let's say it was done right now. This is what it would do next. It's just going to do the wash, or the rinse technically, in the warm water, then just spin out the water, and then you're done, and that's it. So like I said, the manual portion that you do have to do every single time is the part where you have to stop the machine after the first spin, and then set it to spin and pre-wash with the temperature you want. And then after that, it's pretty much set and done. But just keep that in mind, okay? You will have to do this manually every single time you set up the machine for this, okay? So there you guys have it. Hopefully it was a good lesson for you. And if you want to do any kind of rinse in warm water, that's how you do it. Thank you very much for watching, and take care.